Guy Ritchie, I think, brought immeasurable qualities to this film. I mean, everything from its sense of humor to its style to its pace to its tone. You know, as a director of the project, he's really responsible for all of those things. And the fact that it sort of formed into one cohesive project, I think, is also a testament to him.
I agree entirely. I was like, wait, me to talk to? He's unique. That family environment he brings to set, the relaxed atmosphere. I mean, these guys playing guitar in between camera setups, the ability to actually enjoy your lunch as opposed to quickly sort of try and shove it down your throat and eat it off your lap out of a polystyrene carton. He's the guy who'll say, whoa, sit down at this table here, which he has this little tent with all his cameras in and stuff, is his monitors. He says, enjoy your lunch. If we need to, we'll go 20 minutes longer because just eat. We're civilized here. And at the end of the day, you still know it's going to be a great product. It's professional and efficient. It's not lackadaisical. It's just enjoyable.
I would describe Ilya as a sort of... a
stick up his ass.
Yeah. He's just like a blunt instrument in a world where sometimes the velvet touch that Napoleon Solo can apply is slightly more effective. He comes from a very different place than, you know, Europe. I mean, he's about as Soviet as it gets and has very Soviet sensibilities, which sometimes seem completely out of place.
And Napoleon is the polar opposite. He's the guy who will do the job, but enjoy it as much as possible and take as much as he can from the people who are financing the operation to give himself that much more luxury. He's the guy who skims the stuff off the top. And their relationship, they come to loggerheads nonstop. They are completely polar opposites as far as characters are concerned. But they're ultimately... the same coin. I mean, two sides of the same coin is what they are, and they're two halves of the perfect spy. Do we?
I don't think so.
No. What were you? There was... I think you were just Hammer or Army.
Yeah.
Guy called me MOS.
Yeah, MOS, that was it. Yeah.
Man of Steel. In stereo.
Yeah. I don't know that it necessarily would have been that helpful. I did go back and watch the original series, more just sort of like for information purposes than actual character purposes or basing anything off of this modern interpretation off of the show. Because they're very different creatures. You know, the TV show was great and great for the time. But like a lot of shows from the 1960s, it doesn't have an audience right now. It doesn't have a place. So what we were able to do is take the great elements from the TV show and all of the elements that people will nostalgically remember and sort of repackage them in a new, stylized, fun, sexy Guy Ritchie project.
I did not know. I just wanted to start with a clean slate and a clean canvas. And... yeah, I just felt that's the best way for me to operate.
I don't know.
Just the romantic ideal. It's not like real spies. Real spies is really scary. And these are grey men who disappear into the background. But definitely the spy genre is the romanticized version with very talented, strong alpha males and beautiful, gorgeous, strong women as well who control these alpha males. It's got something for everyone and, you know, it's got great gadgets, nice cars and great adventure. What's not to like? I don't know about being in spy movies, but maybe being the romanticized spy.
Yeah.
I mean, who didn't run around
and then, like you said, and then the next day you dream that you're an astronaut, and then the next day you're a cowboy, and then you know, it's all. I think it's pretty much all what movies are, sort of like embodiments of the fantasies that you had as a kid. That's why you want to go watch them, right?
Yeah.
Not really, no.
Yes, he was a Russian spy.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't necessarily draw like from his accent or anything like that, but I was around a lot of Russian people, you know, because he was Russian. So the accent didn't sound as foreign to me as maybe trying to do like a Norwegian accent or somewhere where I don't know a lot of people from Norway, you know. So it started more familiar for me, which was helpful.